Okay, here we are again. So, by the end of the last part, basically the big reveal. I'm going to put it together. So for any one of you who hasn't put it together quite, you are in fact playing as the son of Andrew Ryan and Jasmine Jolene, who was basically mind-controlled by Dr. Souchong to obey any order if it starts out with "would you kindly." That is basically the trigger phrase for the mind control. And that's all I'm going to say for now, because there's going to be another reveal. But this is basically the first big reveal of the game. So there you are. There you have the connections. This is you, or this is me. This is what we're playing as. And yeah, well, I don't know if you saw this reveal coming, but I know that the game has sprinkled hints all throughout the game. And yeah, I mean, Ryan even calls you his child very shortly before you step into this room. And there's going to be one other reveal, but this is what we found out now, and it's yeah, it's pretty heavy. I remember the first time I was completely blown away by this reveal. And without further ado, now that's almost all cards lay on the table, that's basically also the explanation, by the way, why the Vita Chamber is working for you, because, and why the Bathyspheres are working for you, because you have Ryan's genetic code, which basically overrides everything in Rapture. So this is why only you can use the Bathyspheres, and why only you are able to be revived in the Vita Chambers. So yeah, anyway, moving on. Going to Ryan to ask for some more oh my god, this leads directly into his office, I forgot! I can't see shit. Wait, why can I... What do I... I can't see...
The assassin has overcome my final defense. And now he's come to murder me.
Andrew...
In the end, right. What separates a man from a slave? Money? Power? No. A man chooses.
A slave obeys.
You think you have memories. A farm. A family. An airplane. A crash. And then this place. Was there really a family?
Did that airplane crash?
Or was it hijacked? Forced down. Forced down by something less than a man, something bred to sleepwalk through life until they are activated by a simple phrase spoken by their kindly master. Was a man sent to kill or a slave? A man chooses. A slave obeys. Come in.
By the way, a man chooses, a slave obeys is one of my favorite video game quotes of all time. I just love it. I love it because of its simplicity and what it implies. Oh my god, it's so good. Well then, Andrew, we finally meet face to face. Andrew Ryan, or should I say, father?
Stop, would you kindly? Would you kindly? Powerful phrase. Familiar phrase.
Would you kindly head to Ryan's office and kill the son of a bitch?
Sit. Would you kindly? Stand. Would you kindly? Run. Stop. Turn. A man chooses. A slave obeys. Kill!
Oof. He's still standing.
A man chooses!
Still standing. Well, kneeling, but Still getting up. Damn.
Obey!
Well, he's not getting up after that. Powerful stuff.
Hurry now! Grab Ryan's genetic key! Now would you kindly put it in that goddamn machine?
Well, would I now? Well, the game basically doesn't give you any choice but to obey. But I love Ryan's point here. Like, he could have easily killed you right now. Right this instant, he could have just basically forced you to commit suicide, right? But he doesn't. Because he wanted to make the point that you are nothing but a slave that has to obey his orders. No matter what the orders are, and even if we exactly know who the orders come from. Because by now we basically find out that Atlas has manipulated us all the way through. Because he just had to utter a single phrase and... And Atlas knew about everything, by the way. That's also the big reveal here, so... Yeah! The only thing that's left is to find out who Atlas really is, but... I'm sure by now, you can probably guess. Fuck you. Sorry, his laughter is just contagious.
It's time to end this little...
And? Who is it? You tell me.
There ain't no Atlas, kid. Never was. Selling my line of work takes on a variety of aliases. Hell, once... I was even a Chinaman for 6 months. But you've been a sworn. So I guess I owe you a little honesty. The name's Frank Fontaine.
That's right, Frank fucking Fontaine.
I gotta say, I had a lot of business partners in my life. But you, of course, the fact that you were genetically conditioned to bark like a cocker spaniel when I said, would you kindly, might have had something to do with it, but still. Now as soon as that machine finishes processing the genetic key you just fished off Ryan, I'm gonna run Rapture tits to toes. You've been a pal, but you know what they say? Never mix business with friendship. Thanks for everything, kid. Don't forget to say hi to Ryan for me.
You fucking bastard. I'm going to... Oh! Little
Watch
sister!
Out, mister!
Little sister, leave me out of here!
Lead me to safety!
Follow me.
Did I... I just jumped on her head. I will follow you. No! Thanks. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Come with me!
Yes, I will. Ah! Am I dead? I'm not dead. I can hear my heartbeat. And I'm still breathing, so I'm... Olympus Heights. That's right. Ladies and gentlemen, guys and gals, the first half of this game is actually only through because there are still some things to come. So if you thought this was over when Andrew Ryan is dead...
Welcome back.
Oh, that's right, Dr. Tenenbaum knew all along as well.
Yes? Now you know the truth. You are his tool.
Well, I...
Brought back to Rapture to save him.
Oh my god, yeah, of course.
I owe you a debt.
Okay, so...
While you sleep,
sorry,
I
don't want to...
some of Fontaine's mental conditioning.
You can do that?
The control is no longer complete.
There she is.
But he can still pull some very unpleasant... Treat your mind with many locks and keys. Fontaine has most of those keys, but not all.
Suchong.
Suchong designed your mind, taught Fontaine to control you. You might find answers in Su Chong's flat in Mercury Suites.
Okay, so I'm going to put it together real quick for you again. So Andrew Ryan had a child with Jasmine Jolene, and Jasmine Jolene sold that kid to Dr. Su Chong, right? Or gave it to him. I don't know the details, but basically Dr. Su Chong got his hands on the child. Dr. Su Chong was working for Fontaine Industries, and well, Ryan didn't know that, but he suspected as much. Then Dr. Su Chong programmed the child to basically obey every command, then sent the child away to just one day when Fontaine needs him the most trigger the code phrase for him to come to Rapture, and then basically obey his bidding. So that is what happened, and now we're here, and this is how we ended up here. Anyway, I'm going to make a cut here, just because, well, now begins the second half. I don't know if it's really half-half, or is it like two-thirds, one-third. But now begins a whole new part of the game, basically, and I just think there's going to be a cut here would be very cool, so I'm going to make a cut here. And yeah, big reveal, twist reveal. I don't know if you saw it coming, probably because the game is out, has been out for some long time now, but I didn't want to spoil anything for people who haven't played the game yet. And well, now the cat's out of the bag, and yeah, I hope you enjoyed the last few parts, the last two parts, the last parts. I hope I can record a little bit, a few more parts in the next days than usual, actually. And thanks to everyone who has subscribed to me during the last 2 weeks. There were a lot of people. Only a few of them were shown to me, but I know there's a lot, like my subscriber count jumped like 30 subs or something like that, so thank you for that, and I hope I'll see you in the gameplay videos as well as the meme videos. until next time, have a nice day, have a nice night, and of course, as always, have a nice time.